Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I am going to be doing a favorites video. Now, I haven't done a June, July, favorites video just because I've moved countries and it took us a while to find an apartment and then get the internet connection up. So I'm really just doing this. This is going to be a June, July, August collective favorites, and there aren't going to be a lot of products because I simply have not been shopping much. I haven't been using a lot of makeup. So there's going to be maybe 10 items on this and plus one favorites person. Okay, so let's get on with it. First thing, I will start with the body product just because I've only got one. And this is the Bath & Body Works, the Sweetheart's Berry Flirt Triple Moisture Body Cream. I have been loving this product. The first thing that caught my attention was, of course, the packaging. I'm not a pink loving person, but when I saw this, I thought, that's really cute. It reminds me of Barbie. I don't know why, it just does. And then I smelt it, and it smelled like berry candies. So, and plus, it was reduced from 50 dirhams to 20. So I was like, that's mine. I'm not gonna let go of it because this was, they only had a few stocks of it. I don't even know if it's gonna be available when I come back. So anyways, I've been loving this. It smells really good. It's very moisturizing. And I don't feel greasy after applying it. Like I would, you know how the weather is here in, or the climate here in Dubai is. It's currently summer and it's about 40 to 45 degrees Celsius. Okay. Translated into Fahrenheit, I don't know what it is. I'm not even gonna bother, but that's how hot it is outside. So when I put this on, and even if I feel a bit sweaty with the heat, I don't feel greasy. So I love this, and I don't have to put a perfume on when I use this because it smells really good already. Like we had one of our guests come the other day and he was like, oh, what perfume are you wearing? I'm like, I'm actually not wearing any perfume, it's just my body lotion. And Duncan was like, yeah, she smells good all the time. So, well, anyways. And then my next favorite is a face product, and it is one that I use to remove my makeup before I do a proper cleansing, and it is the Bourjois Micellar Cleansing Water. I'm not sure if it's available everywhere, but I have found it in Dubai and it's always stocked at the Gion supermarket here at the Ibn Battuta Mall. So I've been loving this. It removes my makeup without leaving any oily film just because there's no oil in it. It's essentially water with micro, how do you call it? Very small atoms of oil. If that makes sense, I don't know. But when I looked at how it works, there is actually oil in this, but they're so small that they are able to mix with the water, and then it just takes off your makeup without leaving your face looking greasy or oily or shiny. So I use this, and then I do my proper cleansing with a proper facial cleanser, which I don't like. I actually should put that as an unfavorite. I will. I follow that up after a complete cleansing with Boots Simply Sensitive Protecting Day Moisturizer SPF 15. Now, I've got really oily skin, but I found that since I've been using moisturizer, I found that my skin isn't as oily anymore. I guess it's tricking my brain into thinking that I'm producing enough moisture so that they don't have to overproduce oil. Okay, or at least that's the theory behind it. So even if you've got oily skin, make sure that you moisturize, because the reason why your skin is overproducing oil is because it thinks it's dehydrated. So slather on some moisturizer and make sure it's got SPF so that it protects your skin from the sun. Next, I've got eye makeup. And most of this are really rediscovered loves. And this is the Color Tattoo by Maybelline, 24-hour color tattoo in Toughest Taupe in the US, or here it's called Permanent Taupe. And I love this because I started going back to work now. I started work last week, and I want to look put together, but I don't want to look overly made up. So that's why I use this and just an eyeliner, an eyeliner and mascara. The eyeliner that I have been loving is the Physicians Formula Eye Booster 2-in-1 Lash Boosting Eyeliner Plus Serum, and this is in Ultra Black. Now, I completely understand why Cora or Vintage or Tacky loves this eyeliner. It's a brush tip applicator that is so fine point that you can really get in between your lashes, very close to the lash line. You can make a thin line or a thick line with this. I love it, and it stays put all day. Loving it. The other eye product, well, it's not actually an eye product, it's a tool that I have been loving, is my Japanese eyelash curler. I don't know what I'll do without it. Like when it runs out of battery, I get really frustrated because I don't want to use my crimper, lash crimper thing, because that just makes my lashes look and it doesn't really hold the curl well, whereas this, I love it. It's so easy. There is no danger of you crimping your eyelids. So, yep. Love this. Then, face products. I've got two products for Models Prefer, which I have on my cheeks right now. They're both on my cheeks right now. And these are their blush and bronzer. Now, this came with a bronzer stick, and this came with a blush stick as well. It's in their Beauty To Go box. Unfortunately, this is only available in Priceline in Australia. The blush is called Desk To Date, which is a coral peach. And the bronzer is called Glowing, which is a matte cool brown. And that's what I have on my cheeks today. I've layered the bronzer with the blush. Yep. And that uses as almost a contour right there. Then for lips, I have been loving the Nivea Lip Butter Vanilla and Macadamia. That's what it looks like. And just because it smells so good, I love anything vanilla. And if you add macadamia to it, there's no question I'm gonna go get it. It does leave a white sheen on your lips when you put it on, but I usually use this in the evening anyway when I'm going to sleep, so it doesn't really matter. And what I always wake up with supple lips when I use this. I'm wearing this today underneath another product, which is the Revlon Sweet Tart. This is the Revlon Color Burst Lip Butter, and that's what it looks like. I don't know how to describe the kind of pink that it is. It looks like a Barbie pink to me. Okay, I'm not a big fan of pink, but somehow this, because it's sheer, it just makes your lips look a little bit more pink, especially if you're someone like me who's got a very pigmented lip. It looks a bit more pink and more supple, or at least I think so. Okay, so those are my favorites. Now I have two things. I'm actually gonna go get the third item that is in my, that's not a favorite. Let me just go get that. The first unfavorite product is the Boots Sakura Blossom and Lemon Whitening Facial Foam for dull skin. Now I've noticed that my skin has gone dull and I've got a bit more of brown spots around, so I decided I was going to get something that would lighten that, and saw this on Boots, and it was on sale. It was 15 dirhams, buy one get one. So of course I went ahead and got two of them. I've been using it for a week now, and what I've noticed is it didn't help my skin at all. It actually made it worse. I now have even more white bumps on my forehead, and I've noticed a little bit of them forming around here as well, so I've actually stopped using it. And then I looked at the ingredients at the back, and there's like maybe 30 ingredients on this, and I was like, no way am I going to use that. I used to use the Cetaphil Gentle Cleanser, but it's not available here in Dubai, so I thought I'd try something else. And silly me, didn't even bother to look at the ingredients. I should have seen that it had a lot of, it's even got perfume in there in the upper third of the ingredient list. So I was like, that's not good. And it's not paraben free either. I mean, what did I expect with 15 dirhams? 15 dirhams is about, what, $4? So anyway, I don't like this. I think it worsened my skin. I had high hopes because I did like the Simply Sensitive moisturizer, but this one just, it makes your skin, like when you use it as a cleanser, it makes your skin squeaky clean, you know, it feels really tight. And I don't know if that's good. I feel like it dries out my skin, and then I realized that I was starting to get bumps all over my face. So I've stopped actually using it. Probably give this away or throw it out, whatever. The next thing is the Bioderma Sensibio H2O. Or this is essentially the same as the Borjuis one that is in my favorites. Now, don't get me wrong. I like this. I do. I just think that it's too expensive for what it is. This is 33 dirhams, or about $9, or $9.50. Whereas this one is 19 dirhams, or about $5.50. Or actually, it's about $6. $6, yeah. It's about $6. Now, this is 100 ml, and this is 250 ml. You get my point? If I can get something just as good for less the price and more product, I'd definitely go with it. So, I'm not going to be repurchasing the Bioderma. Like I said, don't get me wrong, I do like the product. I think it works really well. I just think that it's too expensive for what it is, for the size of it and the amount of product that you get. I know there are different sizes, but that also comes with different prices. So I'm probably going to use this up, and then I'm just going to refill the bottle with the Borjuis one. And the last unfavorite product is my Smashbox Full Exposure Mascara. Now, I know other people like this. The only reason that I don't like it is because for an Asian who's got short, sparse lashes, okay, this has got a pretty big wand. And whenever I use it, the formula's great. I like the formula. But whenever I use this, because the wand is so huge, I always end up getting mascara on my lid, no matter how careful I apply it. No matter if I don't really go all the way down to the base because I'm afraid of poking my eye with a big wand, it still transfers. Now, it's called full exposure mascara because I do believe it's meant to be volumizing. But for volume, usually that's for people like me who's got sparse lashes, who's got short lashes. And to put a big wand for somebody like me, that's asking for trouble. So anyway, that's my unfavorite. Now, I mentioned I did have one YouTuber favorite, and her channel is called Cloudy Apples. I'm going to link that down below. And I don't know, I just encountered her in one of my recommended videos, and I thought that the video quality was great, but what's even better is the content. She has actually inspired me to look into more natural and even organic ways of maintaining your skin. She uses the Juice Beauty, I think it's the apple one, or is it the lemon? I'm not really sure, but I'm gonna link her video below. She talks about skincare and why your cleanser isn't working for you. And she made me realize that's true, right? Like, a lot of these cleansers strip your skin of its natural moisture. The pH balance is disturbed, so you need to bring back that pH balance to equilibrium. And I don't know, she just made so much sense to me. I'm going to link her down below, and you can go ahead and decide for yourself if you want to subscribe to her. But I like her. Thanks for watching. Bye.